Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today we have Ali here. Ali is a fantastic YouTuber who dives into everything from student life all the way to his work as a junior doctor. So maybe you can dive a bit more into what your channel covers.
Yeah, so hey guys, my name's Ali. I'm a junior doctor. I work in Cambridge where I was a student, and I've been making videos for about 2 years, a little bit about how to be a more productive, more efficient student with evidence-based study tips, but also vlogs and things about life as a medical student and now life as a doctor. And on the side, I do tech reviews of things like, you know, iPads and MacBooks and iPhones and stuff. So, you know, a little bit of everything, but with a theme of productivity running through it. Yeah, similar to yours,
yeah.
I guess.
Yeah, and you recently discovered Notion, right?
I did, yes. And I saw all your videos about Notion because you know, if you search for Notion on the internet, you just see your stuff, yeah, which is amazing.
Bloody pain. But we'll be diving into Ali's Notion account today. We're also going to be over on his channel. So do make sure to subscribe to him because fantastic content right there.
Thank you.
We're going to be diving into productivity apps on his channel. So for students, if you follow the Keep Productive channel and you want app advice, go there because you'll find it.
Hopefully.
We're going to dive into the Notion account now. So here it is in front of us. And what we're going to do is sort of ask Ali plenty of questions about how he uses it. So obviously you found Notion, sort of discovered it maybe a couple of months ago,
yeah, a couple of months ago, I think. I've been using it for about a month.
Fantastic.
Properly.
In active use. Yeah. So what's your sort of primary use for it then? How would you say you use it?
So that's something that I haven't fully worked out yet. I use it for most of my note-taking needs now. I use the iPad Pro with Notability for handwritten notes, and I tend to use that for things like taking notes in lectures, but also for planning out rough sketches for videos.
Okay.
I just like the ability to be able to annotate things by hand.
Yeah.
But then everything else I pretty much do on Notion. So I use it to plan out my videos. I use it for my own sort of medical exam preparation. I also use it for keeping track of things that I've discovered on the internet or podcasts that I've listened to or book reviews. So I'm kind of trying to pull all the content from my life into Notion as like a second brain almost. I guess you've come across that.
Do you ever use OneNote during university, right?
I used OneNote a bit during university. I used Evernote before that. I used Bear for a while. I've tried so many different apps, and I'm hoping that I'll find one, hopefully Notion, that will become the second brain.
The base,
yeah.
So you use it, you mentioned for the medicine side of stuff, so maybe take us through that first.
Sure, so this is my medicine bit. Homepage still needs a bit of working on, but this is what I want to show you. So the MRCP is the membership for the Royal College of Physicians. So that's a postgraduate medical exam that you have to take if you want to be if you want to progress in your career as a doctor. Then you become a member of the Royal College of Physicians, which is cool. But this is quite a hard exam. It's like your medical school finals, but taken up a notch. I've started using Notion to keep track of my studies in that. So this is let's take a look at clinical hematology and oncology. This is one that I've started to expand upon. So created March 11th, 2019. Oh, that was exactly a month ago. So I've pretty much been using this for a month. And actually, that's a good point. On that note, I really like the table feature of Notion, because then I can sort these different categories, these different subjects, by the number of questions that turn up in the exam. So then obviously I know that I want to be prioritizing clinical sciences and endocrinology over something like ophthalmology that only has 4 questions compared to 15 and 25. So let's look at clinical hematology and oncology, open it as a page. And the cool thing about Notion is the toggle thing. I don't know what it's called. What's it called?
Toggles, yeah.
Yeah, the toggles.
We'll call it toggles.
We'll call it toggles, yeah. and this is just so good because I've never seen such a good toggle feature on any other note-taking app. So what I've done is I've split up the whole of hematology into 3 categories: red cells, platelets, and white cells. And within that, I have tried to split up the subject into further categories. So for example, hemolysis means breakdown of blood cells, macrocytic, big cells, microcytic, miscellaneous. And within each of those, I have their own subcategories. So for example, if we look at hereditary spherocytosis, this is one that I filled in the other day. What I've done, I've created another toggle, and I've got a list of questions. So what is it? What's the inheritance? You know, is it like autosomal dominant or recessive? How pissed off would you be if you got it? This is just like my...
Your way of revising it.
This is my way of revising it, my way of thinking that, okay, if I actually had this condition, hereditary spherocytosis, would it make a big difference to my life? Presentation as in how would a patient present with it, diagnose it, how would you diagnose it, and how would you manage it? And I'm able to have these questions as the first thing I see when I click on hereditary spherocytosis. And then if I want to find the answers, I use another toggle box, and that is where I have the notes for it. And I think this is revolutionary because previously, and I think what almost everyone does when they're students, is that we make notes on topics. Whereas this method of writing questions for ourselves first and only then allowing ourselves to see the notes, that forces us to use active recall, which is the most efficient study technique imaginable. And I've made a video on my channel, if you don't mind me plugging
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah, good.
Where I talk about, I fully talk about the evidence behind active recall in depth. But essentially, you know, it's been proven in like hundreds of studies across psychology done on students that simply rereading notes and summarizing content from a textbook, it doesn't actually help. Whereas retrieving information from your own brain does help.
Yeah, 100%.
So, the idea is that for all of these, over time, I'll expand this Notion notebook so that any disease that I want to go to, I will be able to click on it and see and be able to test myself. Do I really know the answer to these questions? And if not, then I'll be able to read up about it.
Yeah.
And another nice thing is I think there's a thing over here where you can like color code. So let's say green. I might color code in green if I knew the answer, red if I don't know the answer. And I'm hoping that this will be a nice... way to expand my studies.
And one of the questions that I had for you was, obviously, like, this took a bit of time to set up, and like, you know, Notion takes a bit of time to understand as a concept in itself. Do you think that, like, how long would it have taken you to create a page like this? Obviously, adding all the content, but the sort of the mind behind all the toggles.
Yeah, so I think, like, after watching a few of your videos, that was when I had the idea to actually use this for studying, because I think you did a video with Thomas Frank where he was showing his method for using Notion, and I just thought, oh wow, this would apply really nicely to kind of to medicine stuff.
Yeah.
So it didn't actually take that long. I think once you get the hang of it, it becomes very easy to just create a new toggle, and then you learn the keyboard shortcuts, like, you know, for example, like the tabbing thing and how tabbing creates a new toggle and stuff like that that you pick up quite quickly through using it.
I don't even know many of the shortcuts, so you're beating me.
Tab to go back.
I need to learn it. But you also showed me earlier the... So Ali's very much of a self-development individual. He tries to improve himself on a routine basis, which is good.
We all do, I think.
And you take notes on like podcasts you've listened to, things like that. And you started making like almost like a notebook calendar to some extent. So maybe take us through that. So
this is my resonance calendar. It's just like a really pretentious name for things that resonate with me. And again, like the nice thing about Notion is that you can view it as a list. You can view it as a calendar. You can view it as a table. So what I do is that if I ever come across something that resonates with me, then I use the iPhone share feature the Notion clipper to put it into Notion, and then I just write a few things from there. So for example, on the 23rd of March, I was clearly being very unproductive creatively, but I watched a lot of content. And for example, Sean Blanc's iPad blogging workflow, the suite setup. So I shared this to Notion just so I have it for later. And I commented, good length and detail in breaking down the nerdy details. I should do more of this. So when I read this particular article, I thought, oh, wow, this is a really great breakdown of how he uses the iPad. Maybe I could do an article like this. So I thought I'd share it to my residence calendar. There was this Y Combinator podcast interview with MKBHD, one of my favorite YouTubers. And this is where I took some notes about production value. Striving for the highest is surely a good thing. Does that mean I should get the A7 III, which is now the camera that we're filming this on? So I think this is nice because... Now, when I consume content, I do it with the intention of, okay, what am I actually learning from this?
Yeah.
And have I got an excuse to put it into my Notion thing? And I think just having the app, this is one of those cases where when an app is nicely made, it encourages you to do good things.
Yeah.
For example, Day One, a journaling app, encourages people to journal because it's just such a nice app.
Yeah.
And Notion encourages me to think about what I learned from the content that I consume. So
yeah, it's perfect. Yeah. I mean, that's actually given me a lot of good ideas for myself because, so I have a new area, a calendar that's called Inspiration.
Oh.
But I just haven't found a use for it. So this actually might be like just being able to take inspiration and ideas. So actually I'm probably going to steal Ali's idea.
Absolutely.
And take it up. And you use, just going to that, you use different the database views to toggle between them depending on how you feel.
Yeah, exactly. Right? And so, for example, this was the Tim Ferriss podcast episode with Neil Gaiman that I really enjoyed. So I shared that using Overcast from my iPhone. I was listening to this in the car, so I just stopped by the side of the road and decided to do this. And then I wrote a few notes about it. But also, another nice thing about Notion is the tags feature. So I've tagged it as email favorite, which means I've mentioned this in one of my weekly newsletters where I talk about my favorite things from that week, but also as monthly favorite, because I've mentioned it in one of my monthly favorite videos. And it's just a good way of keeping track of stuff. So for example, you know, I've tagged things with podcast if it's a podcast, so that if I'm looking to recommend a podcast, instead of thinking about, oh, what was that podcast I listened to? Because I guess we both listen to so many.
Yeah.
I just kind of have a quick flick through this and be like, oh, that Farnham Street podcast with Naval was really good.
Yeah.
I'll give you a link.
That's it. Yeah.
So
that's
it's
really
been,
good.
It's been quite handy.
It's like everything you need in one place. It's
yeah.
very neat. And you're also starting to use it as well for video management in terms of for the YouTube side of stuff.
Yeah, that's right. So I've done it in terms of this like Kanban board, I think.
That's yeah, that's the word. Like, yeah.
Where does that come from?
I think it was a Japanese 80s technique that they used in a factory
okay.
to move stuff across, and then they adapted it to the Kanban method.
Oh, that's why. Yeah, because
I'll send you the Wikipedia
Japanese.
Link. Yeah.
So I've got, you know, if I have an idea for a video, I'll put it in here, and I'll put sort of a date where aspirationally I would want to publish the video, which is where the calendar comes in as well. So that was this video, how I came first, it came from memorizing essays. I intended to make a how to spin an Apple Pencil video.
I saw you do that earlier, and I was like, Jesus, yeah, that's impressive.
So let's actually move that across over there. And just,
yeah, you should make it still.
Yeah, I'll make it at some point. But so then if I've planned a video, we'll put it in there. Actually, you know what? Productivity tip for students, we planned that. Notion for students, this one.
You just drag them across the statuses, and it helps
exactly.
you just to keep a good idea of the where you're sort of going with it. Do you ever add, like, obviously you've added there, like, the Tech Essential one, mm-hmm. You've added, like, a sort of script inside the card.
Yeah.
And that helps you just to generally plan the structure of the video, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So, like, there was that one we were doing earlier on my channel, Productivity App, so just kind of planning a quick structure. Sometimes I do write out a proper script, especially if it's like a keynote video almost, where I've put in so much effort into a single video. I will often write out a script, especially if it's a video where I'm talking about the evidence behind things. I can't just remember that off the top of my head. So
yeah,
it's just pretty solid all around for planning videos.
I love it. And maybe talk about a few of the ways that students could potentially use something like this. How would you see maybe a first year that wanted to actually just start using Notion as a way to organize? How do you would give them any introduction tips?
I think the tips I would give is that just to kind of watch how a few other people use Notion. So I think your channel is perfect for that. And then that'll hopefully give you some ideas. One thing I really would recommend is this thing of, if you're making notes, you write questions for yourself. So that it forces you to use active recall. You can also use Notion as a sort of calendar, you can use it as a to-do list, you can use it as a planner, you can use it as a timetable. There's so many different uses for it. And I think it can potentially get a bit overwhelming, but just kind of seeing how other people are using it and starting small, like starting with one thing, maybe just using it for your notes. And you can, you know, drag and drop your lecture handouts like I've done with this particular PDF. Starting small, and then over time you'll be like, oh, this is another use for Notion, and then it kind of expands.
Yeah, I like that. And the thing is as well is, like, I think, like, you're very similar to me. You want to start with like a skeleton of something, then to actually add the flesh later to it, because like, you can go crazy with Notion, like adding all the icons, covers, all the details, but you know, once you've got the general structure, then you can add all the good stuff after, I think.
So. Absolutely. And I think that's a really good tactic for students as well. Like, even with this, even though I only studied hematology that day, I still, you know, put in all of the different subjects just so I have a, you know, bird's eye overview of what this exam is about.
Yeah.
And also within hematology, I've created my bird's eye view before I've gone deep into certain things. It's very easy to get bogged down in the details, but I think what Notion does nicely is that it encourages you to have a bird's eye view of your subject. So that's what I'd recommend for students.
That's brilliant. Thank you, Ali, for coming on today.
Thank you, it's been a pleasure.
You can go and find his YouTube channel in the description below. Just to mention as well, we've also been doing another one. So if you're a student looking for productivity advice and tips, we're going to be talking about that, aren't we?
We're going to be talking
directly after this.
Immediately after this, when we hit the record button again.
That's it. So feel free to go and follow Ali. And also, I made a little sort of student hub that you can duplicate. It's got a simple planner, coursework, and lecture notes abilities. So duplicate it into your Notion, give it a bit of a play around, design it to your own needs, and give that a try. But of course, we'll be doing some more features on it soon. So thanks very much, guys. Make sure to have a great week. Thank you, Ali, for coming on.
Thank you for having me.
And subscribe to us both and hit the like button as well. Thanks, guys.
Bye.